My name is Ritvik Bharadwaj, register number 316. So in the previous classes, our friends spoke about electricity, why it is the most convenient form of energy, what is electric current, what is potential difference, Ohm's law and resistance. So that completes the first unit of the chapter. Today I am going to speak about the second unit, which is system of resistors. In system of resistors, you can connect circuits in two ways. One is series connection and one is parallel connection. In series connection, the resistors are connected end to end in the circuit. In parallel connection, they are connected one below the other parallel. The formula to find the total resistance in series connection is RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. The total resistance of resistors connected in series is equal to the sum of resistances of individual resistors. The formula to calculate resistance of a parallel connection is 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. The reciprocal of the sum of the reciprocal of the resistance of resistors connected in parallel connection is sum of reciprocals of resistances of individual resistors. Now let us look at why parallel connection is opted over series connection. The disadvantages of series connection are, if one device fails in the circuit, the whole circuit breaks down. And in series connection, the resistance is higher than the highest value. And in series connection, since electric gadgets require different amount of electric current, they cannot be connected in series because in a series connection, electric current is constant. So we can say that it is impractical to connect devices with different resistances in series connection because they require different amount of electric current, but in series connection the electric current remains constant. Now the advantages of parallel connection are, since electric current is not constant in parallel connection, each device gets how much electric current is required by it and each device works efficiently. And in parallel connection, if one device fails, the rest of the circuit is still working. In parallel connection, the resistance also decreases than the resistance of the least resistor. So this is why parallel connection is opted over series connection. Thank
you. My name is Nishipayas. My register number is 160. Today I am going to talk about a chapter in physics called electricity. Electricity is the most essential part of our life. Without electricity, most of our works are incomplete. Now let's get into the chapter. First, I am going to give a little introduction about electricity. Electricity is the most convenient form of energy because electricity can be generated in large scale, electricity can be converted easily into other forms of energy, electricity can be easily transmitted to longer distance using transmission lines. Direction of conventional electricity is from positive terminal to negative terminal, but actual electricity flows from negative terminal to positive terminal. Because electricity is nothing but flow of free electrons. Now let's talk about electric current. Electric current is rate of flow of electric charges. Electric current is denoted by the symbol I. The equation used is I is equals to Q by T. Here I stands for electric current, Q stands for quantity of charges, T stands for time. The SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb, the SI unit of time is seconds, the SI unit of electric current is ampere. The smaller units of electric current are milliampere and microampere. Here milliampere refers to 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere and microampere refers to 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere. Now the instrument used to measure electric current is ammeter, which is always connected in series to the circuit. The instrument used to detect electric current is galvanometer. Now let's learn about potential difference. Potential difference is denoted by the symbol V. Potential difference means work done to move a unit charge from one point to another in an electric circuit. Here the equation is V is equal to W by Q. Here V stands for potential difference, W stands for work done, Q stands for quantity of charges. The SI unit of potential difference is volt, the SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb, the SI unit of work done is joule. The instrument used to measure potential difference is voltmeter. It is always connected in parallel to the circuit. Potential difference makes the charges to move from one point to another. Metals are good conductors of electricity because of free electrons. Cells or battery are the best example for potential difference providers. Now let's talk about electric circuit. Electric circuit is a continuous and closed path of an electric current. Electric circuits are made by metals because metals are consisting of free electrons. George Simon Ohm, a German scientist, conducted an experiment to find the potential difference, relationship between the potential difference and electric current. He plotted a graph called VI graph, which is always a straight line graph or linear graph. By using this formula, he formulated a law called Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that potential difference across the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the dielectric current flowing through it at constant temperature. Here the equation is V is equals to I into R. Here V stands for potential difference, I stands for electric current, and R stands for resistance. The SI unit of potential difference is volt, the SI unit of resistance is ohm, and the SI unit of electric current is ampere. Resistance is the property of conductor used to resist flow of electric charges. Factors on which resistance depends on. The resistance of the conductor depends on length of the conductor, area of cross section of the conductor, and nature of the material, resistivity. R is equals to rho L by A. Here R stands for resistance, rho stands for resistivity, L stands for length of the material, A stands for area of cross section. Area of cross section of the conductor. The SI unit of resistivity rho is ohm meter. Now we are going to talk about rheostat. Rheostat is a device and it is a variable resistor to alter electric current without changing potential difference. In electrical heating devices, these coils are made of alloys than metals. Alloys are used for making heating coils because alloys do not oxidize easily like metals when heated in air. Alloys have higher resistance than their constituent metals. Tungsten is a metal which is used in electrical filament lamp. To prevent oxidation in tungsten, nitrogen gas is filled inside the filament lamp. Constantin and its composition. Constantin, copper and nickel. Manganese, copper, nickel. Nickel, chromium, manganese and iron. Now I'm going to talk about there are two methods for connecting resistors in circuit: series connection and parallel connection. In series connection, electric current is constant throughout the circuit. Potential difference varies from resistor to resistor. The sum of equivalent resistance connected in series is equal to sum of resistance of individual resistors. The formula is RS is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. In parallel connection, potential difference is constant throughout the circuit, and electric current varies from resistor to resistor. Reciprocal of resistances of the resistors connected in parallel is equal to sum of reciprocal of resistances of individual resistors. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. This is Prachi Ravi Bagre, and my register number is 164. Today, I'll be talking about electricity. So first, what is electricity? Electricity is a form of energy and it is known as convenient form of energy because it can be produced in a large scale, it can be transported to longer distances using transmission lines, it can be converted to other forms of energy. Next, I'll be talking about electricity. electrons, the current flows from positive terminal to negative terminal, but in actual electricity, the current flows from negative terminal to the positive terminal. Electric current I means the rate of flow of electric charges. Formula is I is equal to Q by T. Here, I represents electric current, Q represents quantity of charges, T represents time. SI units of electric current is ampere, quantity of charges is coulomb, time is seconds. There are smaller units of electric current, that is milliampere, which is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere, and microampere, which is 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere. Ammeter is a device used to measure electric current, and there is another device used to detect electric current, that is galvanometer. Ammeter is always connected in series. 1 coulomb is equal to charge of 16 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons, and charge of 1 electron is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. Next we come to potential difference V. Potential difference means the rate of flow, the rate to move and moving charge from one point to another is in an electric circuit. Formula is V is equal to W by Q. Here V represents potential difference, Q represents W represents work done, and Q represents quantity of charges. SI unit of potential difference is volt, work done is joule, and quantity of charges is coulomb. Next I'll talk about voltmeter is a device used to measure potential difference. It is always connected in parallel. Next I'll be talking about Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that potential difference V at the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current I flowing through it at constant temperature. Formula is V is equal to IR. Here V represents potential difference, I represents electric current, and R represents resistance. SI units of potential difference is volt, electric current is ampere, and resistance is ohm. Now I would like to conclude my explanation by listing all the formulas that come under this chapter. There are 12 formulas in total. I is equal to Q by T, V is equal to W by Q, V is equal to IR, R is equal to AF by A, RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, 1 by R3 is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, H is equal to I square RT, H is equal to VIT, P is equal to W by T, P is equal to I square V, P is equal to V square by R, P is equal to RV. Thank you.
Good evening to one and all present here. I am Vishal P. Bharadwaj from Vijayabharati Vidyalaya School, and my register number is 402. So today I am here to give a presentation on a chapter called electricity. So what is electricity? Electricity is a form of energy, and it is considered as the most convenient form of energy. The reasons are, it can be produced in a large scale, it can be transported from one place to another place easily using transmission lines, and it can be converted into other forms of energy easily. So the next topic is electric current. Electric current, the symbol of electric current is I. So what is electric current? Electric current is the rate of flow of electric charges. The equation to derive is I is equals to Q by T, where I stands for electric current, Q stands for quantity of charges, and T stands for time. And the SI unit of I or electric current is ampere, the SI unit of Q or quantity of charges is coulomb, and the SI unit of T or time is seconds. And 1 coulomb is equal to 6 into 10 power 18 electrons. And the smaller units of electric current is milliampere and microampere. Milliampere equals 10 to the power minus 3 ampere, and microampere equals 10 to the power minus 6 ampere. So the next topic we are moving on is potential difference. So what is potential difference? Potential difference is the work done to move an unit of electric charge from one point to another in an electric circuit. And the symbol of potential difference is V. And there is an equation to derive it, which is V is equals to W by Q, where V stands for potential difference, W stands for work done, and Q stands for quantity of charges. And the SI unit of V or potential difference is volt, and the SI unit of W or work done is joule, and the SI unit of Q or quantity of charges is coulomb.
Good evening everyone, I am Vaishnavi, I am studying in Mookambika School.
Today, I am going to give a presentation on the lesson electricity. So now, what is electricity? Electricity is considered as the most convenient form of energy because of the three reasons. First reason is that it can be converted to any form of energy. It can be generated in large scale. It can be transported from one place to another using transmissions. Moving on to the next topic, electric current. What is electric current? The rate of flow of electricity, electric charges is called as electric current. And the formula which we use for this is I is equals to W by T, in which I means electricity and Q means quantity of charges and T means time. The SI unit of electric current is ampere. The SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb and the SI unit of time is second. Now, what is potential difference? The work done to move an unit of electric charges is called as potential difference. Potential difference, the symbol of potential difference is V. V is equals to W by Q. W means work done and its SI unit is joule and T means and Q means quantity of charges, its SI unit is coulomb. Now, a German scientist conducted an experiment to find the relationship between potential difference and electric current. He found that electric current is directly proportional to potential difference at constant temperature. This was named as Ohm's law. The formula for Ohm's law is I is equals to Vr, in which I means electric current, V means potential difference and R means resistance. The SI unit of potential difference is volt and the SI unit of electric current is ampere and the SI unit of resistance is resistivity. Alloys are used. The SI unit of resistance is ohm. The alloys are used than metals because alloys do not get oxidized like metals. When they are heated in air, they have higher resistance than metals. Here, I would like to conclude my topic and thank you all for giving me this wonderful opportunity. A very good morning to everyone present here. Myself, Riya Singh, studying in 10th standard. My register number is 51. Today's topic is electricity. What is electricity? Electricity is nothing but a form of energy. Electricity is the most convenient form of energy because it can be converted easily into other forms of energy. It can be generated in a large scale and electricity can be transmitted to longer distances through transmission lines. Next is electric current. Electric current means rate of flow of electric charges. The formula is I is equal to Q by T. Here, I stands for electric current, Q stands for quantity of electric charges and T stands for time. Next is potential difference. Potential difference means work done to move a unit charge from one point to another in an electric circuit. The formula is V is equal to W by Q. Here V stands for potential difference, W stands for work done and Q stands for quantity of electric charges. Next, we learn about electric circuit. A closed and continuous path of an electric current is called as electric circuit. An electric circuit is made up of metals because metals have free electrons. Next is Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that potential difference across the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through it at constant temperature. The formula is V is equal to IR. Here V stands for potential difference, I stands for electric current and R stands for resistance. Lastly, it is Ohm's law. Lastly, it is Joule's law of heating. Heat produced in a conductor is directly proportional to the electric current, to the resistance and to the time for which the current flows through it. The formula is H is equal to VIT, but it can also be written as H is equal to I square RT. Now, I'm going to list out all the 12 formulas in the chapter electricity. I is equal to Q by T, V is equal to W by Q, V is equal to IR, R is equal to rho L by A, RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, H is equal to I square RT, H is equal to VIT, P is equal to W by T, P is equal to I square R, P is equal to V square by R, and P is equal to VI. Thank you.
My name is Ankita and my register number is 317 and I am from JHS school. Today I am going to talk about chapter called electricity. And electricity is a form of energy. Electricity is considered as the most convenient form of energy because of three reasons. Electricity can be generated in large scale. Electricity can be easily converted into other forms easily. Electricity can be transmitted from one place to another through transmission lines. The direction of conventional current is from positive to negative, but the actual current flows from negative to positive terminal because electricity is a flow of electrons. Now we'll talk about electric current. What is electric current? The rate of electric charges is known as electric current. The equation is I is equals to Q by T. Here I stands for electric current and the SI unit is ampere. Q stands for quantity of charges and the SI unit is coulomb. T stands for time and the SI unit is seconds. Now ammeter is a device is used to measure electric current and it is always connected in series. Now we'll talk about potential difference. What is potential difference? Potential difference means the work done to move a unit charge from one point to other is known as potential difference. The equation is V is equals to W by Q, where V stands for potential difference and the SI unit is volt, W stands for work done and the SI unit is joule, Q stands for quantity of charges and the SI unit is coulomb. The device used to measure the potential difference is voltmeter and it is always connected in parallel. Now we'll talk about the most important part of this chapter called Ohm's law. The German scientist named George Simon Ohm conducted an experiment to find the relationship between potential difference and the electric current, and he plotted a graph called VI graph and V by I graph, and the graph obtained a straight line graph, and using this result he formulated a law called Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that potential difference at the ends of a conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through it at constant temperature. And the equation is V is equals to IR. Here V stands for potential difference and the SI unit is volt. I stands for electric current and the SI unit is ampere. R stands for resistance and the SI unit is ohm. Resistance means resistance is a property of a conductor to resist the flow of electric charges. And the resistance depends on mainly four factors. Resistance of a conductor depends on length of the conductor, area of cross section and resistivity. And the equation is R is equals to rho L by A. Here R stands for resistance and the SI unit is ohm. Rho stands for resistivity and SI unit is ohm meter. And L stands for length and the SI unit is meter. And area of cross section, A stands for area of cross section and the SI unit is square meters. Now we'll talk about alloys. Alloys are mainly used in making heating coils because alloys do not get oxidized as other metals when they are heated in air. Alloys have higher resistance than rather than its constituent metals. Now we'll talk about heating system of resistors. There are two forms to connect resistors. The first one is series connection and second one is parallel connection. We'll talk about series connection of resistors. In series connection, electric current remains constant and potential difference varies, and the equation is RS is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3, and the second one is parallel connection. In parallel connection, potential difference remains constant and electric current varies, and the equation is 1 by RP is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Now we will talk about heating effect of electric current. When the electric current passes through a conductor, some amount of electric energy is converted into heat energy because of the resistance of the conductor, and this effect of heating electric current is known as heating effect of electric current. Now we'll talk about Joule's law of heating. Joule's law of heating states that the heat produced in a conductor is directly proportional to square of the electric current, resistance of the conductor and time. The equation is H is equals to I square RT. Here H stands for electric energy, heat energy, and it is and its SI unit is joule, and I stands for electric current and the SI unit is ampere, R stands for resistance and the SI unit is ohm, T stands for time and the SI unit is seconds. And this further can be modified into H is equals to VIT. Here H stands for heat energy and the SI unit is joule, and V stands for potential difference and the SI unit is volt, I stands for electric current and the SI unit is ampere, T stands for time and the infinity is seconds. Now we'll talk about power. So what is power? Power means the rate of doing work. Here the equation is P is equals to W by T. Here P stands for power and the infinity is watt, and W stands for work done and the infinity is joule, and T stands for time and the infinity is seconds. This can be further modified into P is equals to V square by R, P is equals to I square R, and P is equals to VI. Thank you. And by this topic, I conclude my presentation. Thank you.
A very good morning to one and all present here. My name is Jai Raghavendra BG. My register number is 76. Today, I'll be speaking about... Any guesses? Yes. I'll be speaking about the very famous Ohm's law. To understand this, I have a simple illustration. To start with, all of you are able to see two streams of blood flowing, right? And the first case, we are able to see that there is no blocks, and in the second case, there is a block. So what is this block doing to the blood? Yes, it is resisting the flow of blood or offering a resistance to the blood. Now, what is resistance? Resistance is the property of a conductor to resist the flow of electricity in it. Same way, as the blockage here is blocking the blood, a conductor has a property of resisting the flow of electrons. Now, coming back to the Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? Ohm's law states that the potential difference at the two ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through it at a constant temperature. Now, this Ohm's law was given by a great German scientist called George Simon Ohm. Now, we all get a question here. How was this scientist able to formulate this law? He took different values of the potential difference and observed the corresponding electric current, and using these values, he plotted a graph. And the result was a straight line. And this graph is called a straight line or a linear graph. So we can conclude that whenever we plot a VI graph, we get a straight line. Using this graph and some knowledge of resistance, the scientist George Simon Ohm was able to formulate this Ohm's law. He also gave out an equation, that is V is equals to IR. Here V stands for the potential difference, I stands for the electric current, and R stands for the resistance. The SI unit of potential difference is volts, and that of electric current is amperes, and that of resistance is ohm. Using this one V is equals to IR formula, we can get other three formulas. That is, it can be understood by this triangle. Now, here, if we want the value of V, we can multiply I and R. And if we want the value of I, we can divide V by R. And if we want the value of R, we can divide V by I. I would like to conclude my presentation by some applications of this Ohm's law. Everybody would have seen a fan, right? Yes, the regulation of this speed in the fan is an application of Ohm's law. It is used in the basic designing of many machines and electrical circuits. Also, it is used in various heaters and irons.
My name is Harshita. I'm going to talk about my register number is 54. I'm going to talk about the first chapter in physics called electricity. Electricity is a conventional form of energy because it can be transmitted to longer distance through transmission lines. It can be generated in large scale. It can be converted into other forms of energy. And if the direction of the electric conventional form of energy is from positive terminal to negative terminal, but the actual energy flows from negative terminal to positive terminal. The electric current is nothing but the rate of flow of electric charges. The formula is I is equal to Q by T. I stands for electric current, Q stands for quantity of charges, and T stands for time. The SI unit of I is, the SI unit of electricity is ampere, and the SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb. The SI unit of time is seconds. There are two smaller units in the electric current called milliampere and microampere. Milliampere is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere. Microampere is equal to 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere. the one coulomb of charge is equal to 6 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. The one charge of an electron is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 electrons. The instrument which is used to measure the electric current is an ammeter, and the instrument which is used to detect the electric current is galvanometer. The potential difference is the work done to move an unit charge from one point to another point in an electric circuit. The formula is V is equal to W by Q. V stands for potential difference and W stands for work done and Q stands for quantity of charges. The SI unit of potential difference is volt. The SI unit of work done is joules and the SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb. The instrument which is used to measure potential difference is voltmeter. The metal, the cell or battery are the best examples for potential difference. Electric circuit is a continuous or closed path of an electric current. They are made up of metals because of the free electrons present in the metals. George Simon Ohm was a German scientist. He formulated the law called Ohm's law. He plotted it on a graph. He made a VI graph to find the relationship between the potential difference and the electric current. The Ohm's law states that the potential difference at the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through it at a constant temperature. The formula he used is V is equal to IR. V stands for potential difference, I stands for electric current, and R stands for resistance. The SI unit of potential difference is volt. The SI unit of electric current is ampere, and the SI unit of resistance is ohm. In Ohm's law, we introduce a new term called resistance. Resistance is a property of a conductor to resist the flow of electric charges. It is based on three factors, that is resistivity and the length of the conductor and the area of cross section. The formula is R is equal to rho L by A. If the length of the conductor increases, the resistance increases and the current decreases. If the thickness of the wire increases, the resistance decreases and the electric current increases. Rheostat, we use a device called rheostat, and it is a variable resistor. It is used to alter the electric current without changing the potential difference. The alloys are used in making heating electrons because alloys do not get oxidized easily like metals, and it has the higher resistance more compared to the metals. And there are the three alloys are the constantan and manganese and nichrome. Constantan consists of copper and nickel. Manganese consists of copper, nickel and manganese. Nichrome consists of nickel, chromium, iron and manganese. Thank you.
First of all, I want to thank KKN sir for giving me this opportunity. Myself, Vinit VK from Vijayabharti School, and my register number is 61. I want to tell you about the electricity chapter. What is electricity? Electricity is a form of energy, and it is a conventional convenient form. What is electric current? Rate of flow of electric current is known as rate of flow of electric charges are known as electric current. What do you mean by potential difference? Potential difference means work done to move a charge of electrons from one point to another is known as potential difference. Its equation is V is equal to W by Q. Here V is equal to volt or potential difference. W means work done. Its SI unit is joule. Q means quantity of charges. Its SI unit is coulomb. What do you mean by Ohm's law states that potential difference at the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to electric current flowing through it at the constant temperature is known as Ohm's law. Its equation is V is equal to IR. V means volt or potential difference. I means electric current. Its SI unit is ampere. R means resistance, its SI unit is ohm. George Simon Ohm discovered the graph called VI graph. Resistivity equation is R is equal to rho L by A. Here R is equal to resistance, its SI unit is ohm. Rho means resistivity. Rho means resistivity, its SI unit is rho, ohm meter. L means length of a conductor, A means area of cross section of a conductor. There are two ways to connect electric circuit, namely series connection and parallel connection. In series connection, the electric current is in constant and voltage in varies. Its equation is Rs is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, and in parallel connection V is equal to V is constant and electric current is in varies. Its equation is R1 by R3 is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Joule's law of heating energy. Heat produced to a conductor directly proportional to square of electric current, resistance of a conductor and time. Its equation is H is equal to I square RT. H is equal to I square RT. H is equal to heat. SI unit is Joule.
Hi everyone, my name is Shriyavi. I'm studying in Sri Kumari Children's Home and my register number is 71. So today we're going to discuss about the first physics chapter, that is electricity. So what do you mean by electricity? Electricity is the form of energy. So electricity is considered as the most convenient form of energy because it can be produced or generated in large scale. It can be converted into other forms of energy and it can be transmitted to longer distances using transmission lines. The conventional form of electricity is from positive terminal to negative terminal. It flows from positive terminal to negative terminal. But the actual electricity flows from negative terminal to positive terminal. This is because electricity is nothing but flow of electrons. Okay? So now, I will explain you what is electric current. Is denoted by the symbol I. The symbol is I. And then what is electric current? Electric current is the rate of flow of electric charges. It's the rate of flow of electric charges. Okay, and there is a formula for this. There is an equation for this. I is equal to Q by T. So here, I stands for electric current. And Q stands for quantity of charges. And T stands for power. can also write time taken. So I stands for electric current, Q stands for quantity of charges, and T stands for time. And now we'll go for the SI units. So SI unit of electric current. SI unit of electric current is ampere. SI unit of electric current is ampere. Its symbol is A, capital A. SI unit of electric current is ampere. Then SI unit of quantity of charges. SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb. So I'll just mark this because it's very important. SI unit of electric current is ampere. Symbol is A. SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb. Symbol is C. Okay, and SI unit of time. Of time is seconds. Seconds. Symbol is yes. So I'm going to repeat it again. So I is equal to Q by T is the equation for electric current. Okay, here I is equal to electric current, or I stands for electric current, Q stands for quantity of charges, T stands for time. SI units. SI unit of electric current is ampere. Symbol is A. SI unit of quantity of charges. Quantity of charges is coulomb. Symbol is C. SI unit of time is second. So now we go to smaller units of electric current. Smaller unit of electric current. Smaller unit of electric current. So there are two small units. First one is milliampere. Milliampere. Symbol is M A. Or the capital milliampere. Symbol is M A, which is equal to 10^-3 ampere. 10^-3 ampere. Okay. There are two units. First is milliampere. Symbol is MA is equal to 10^-3 ampere. Second one is microampere. Microampere. Symbol is, it's like a U, but it's not a U. It is called as micro in Greek. Okay. So it's like this and A. This value is 10^-6 ampere. Okay. So smaller units of electric current, there are two smaller units of electric current. First one is milliampere. Symbol is MA, means the value of it is 10^-3 ampere. And second one is microampere. Microampere, and then 10^-6 ampere. So we have, we know about coulomb. Okay, coulomb. So 1 coulomb is equal to 10^6 of 18. Okay, 1 coulomb is equal to 10^6 of 18 electrons. Okay, smaller units are 2 smaller units, and 1 coulomb is equal to 10^6 of 18 electrons. Okay, so now we'll come to instruments. Which is used to measure electric current is ammeter. Ammeter. Instrument used to measure electric current is ammeter. Instrument which is used to detect electric current is galvanometer. Okay, so instrument which is used to measure electric current is ammeter, which is always connected in series. Okay, instrument is used to detect electric current is galvanometer. So 1 coulomb is equal to 10 into 60 to the power of 18 electrons. But what is the value of 1 electron? So 1 electron is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. Okay, so 1 coulomb is equal to, I told you. So what is 1 electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. So now we'll move on to potential difference. So potential difference, the symbol of potential difference is V. The symbol of potential difference is V. Okay. So what do you mean by potential difference? Potential difference means work done to move an unit charge from one point to another in an electric circuit. Okay. I'll write it. Potential difference V means work done to move an unit charge from one point to another, from one point to another in an electric circuit. In an electric circuit. Okay, what is potential difference? Put work done to move a unit charge from one point to another in an electric circuit. So its symbol is V. Okay, this has a formula. V is equal to W by Q. V is equal to W by Q is a equation for potential difference. So here V is equal to, you have to complete the sentence, V stands for dash dash. So I'm going to write just V is equal to potential difference W is equal to work done and Q is equal to quantity of charges. Okay, here V is equal to potential difference, W is equal to work done, Q is equal to quantity of charges. So we move on to SI units. I'm just going to write next to it, but you have to write it in a sentence. V, SI unit of potential difference, SI unit of potential difference is volt, volt, V-O-L-T, volt. And SI unit of work done is joule. SI unit of potential difference is volt. SI unit of work done is joule and SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb. Okay, so you can also write the symbols V and J C. So I want to repeat it. Now we studied about potential difference. What is potential difference? Work done to move a unit charge from one point to another in an electric circuit. Okay? Here is the formula or equation. V is equal to W by Q. Here, V is equal to potential difference. Its SI unit is volt. Potential difference, SI unit is volt. Okay? And W. W is equal to work done. SI unit of W, that is work done, is joule. Then Q. Q is quantity of charges. SI unit of quantity. quantity of charges is coulomb. Okay, instrument used to measure potential difference is voltmeter. Okay, instrument used to measure potential difference is voltmeter. It is always connected parallel to the circuit. Okay, electric current, it will be connected in series. Here it will be connected parallel to the circuit. Metals are the good conductors of electric current because of free electrons. Okay, so cell and the battery are the good examples for potential difference providers. Okay, now we'll move on to electric circuit. What do you mean by electric circuit? Electric circuit is the continuous and closed path of electric current. Okay, electric circuit means continuous and closed path of electric current. Okay, singular resistor. Next, variable resistor. It's like this, and you have to draw an arrow mark towards up arrow mark. This is variable resistor. 10th one is rheostat. Rheostat. It's like this. And like this. Rheostat. And then ammeter. It's just circle and A inside it. And then voltmeter. Inside it B. So now there's a question here. Make a circuit with a cell, open switch and an ammeter. So here is the question, make a circuit with a cell, open with an ammeter. So there are two questions, so we will solve the first one. Make a circuit. Circuit is always a closed path. This is called as a circuit. This is called as a circuit. So with a cell, you can draw a cell here. See, what cell? Yeah, the cell symbol is this, so we have it. So you can add more than one cell also. And then here, next, open switch. Open switch. Open switch, see, like this. And then ammeter. Ammeter you can draw wherever you want. I'm going to draw it here. Ammeter. So this is the answer for the first question. So second question. Cell, closed switch, resistor, ammeter and voltmeter. So firstly I'll draw resistor. Resistor symbol here. This is the resistor symbol. So here and then this. So open, resistor open. Ammeter. Okay, I'll take voltmeter now. So only voltmeter will be connected parallel to the resistor. Here I'm going to draw the voltmeter. Voltmeter over. Now I'm going to draw ammeter here. So you can also show that electricity is, yeah, it's a closed path. So now, yeah, then the answer is to ammeter over. Close the switch. So close switch here. Ammeter symbol. Voltmeter symbol. Okay. And now cell. You have to join this cell. So this is a complete thing. This is positive, negative. And you can show that the current is continuously in a closed path. So this is the complete answer. So for this circuit diagram, you need these symbols. That's why I firstly draw the symbols and then I show you how to draw a circuit. Okay. Now we move on to Ohm's law. This is very very important in this chapter. 100% this will come in the public examination. So please practice this carefully. Okay. So Ohm's law. So what is Ohm's law? Ohm's law states that potential difference at the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through it at constant temperature. As calculated. Ohm's law states that potential difference at the end of the conductor, at the ends of the conductor, is directly proportional to electric current flowing through it at constant temperature. Okay, I repeat it for the third time. Ohm's law states that potential difference at the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through the difference. That is V. At the ends of the conductor, it is directly proportional potential difference at the end of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through it at constant temperature. Okay, potential difference at the end of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through it at constant temperature. So this has a formula or an equation. V is equal to IR. Here V is constant. Okay? V is constant. So this is the equation of Ohm's law. So now here V is equal to, or if correct, V stands for potential difference and I stands for electric current and lastly R stands for resistance. What resistance? So here B stands for potential difference, I stands for electric current, R stands for resistance. Now SI unit. SI unit of potential difference is voltmeter. SI unit of potential difference is, sorry, volt. SI unit of potential difference is volt. SI unit of electric current is ampere. Okay. SI unit of resistance is ohm. Okay, you can write back in bracket V, I, resistance, you can write R, is Ohm. Ohm symbol is this. Okay, Ohm symbol, you can write it like this. This is Ohm symbol. And repeated, potential difference at the end of the conductor is directly proportional to the electric current flowing through it at constant temperature. So here, V is equal to potential difference. I is equal to electric current, R is equal to resistance, SI unit of potential difference is volt, SI unit of electric current is ampere, SI unit of resistance is ohm. So now, what is resistance? Resistance is the property of a conductor to resist the flow of electric charge. So now we'll move on to resistance, okay? What do you mean by resistance? Resistance means is the property of a conductor to resist the flow of electric charge. Okay, resistance is the property of a conductor to resist the flow of electric charge. Okay, its SI unit is. So, George Simon Ohm is a German scientist. He conducted an experiment. experiment to find out the relationship between electric current and potential difference. Okay, he ended up plotting a VI graph. VI graph is always a straight line or a linear graph. Okay, using this information, he found out Ohm's law. Okay, the VI graph, I'll show you how the VI graph will be. So this is a graph, 1, 2, 3, etc. and here also. So when he conducted an experiment, he got a straight line. He got a straight line. So this is called as VI graph. Now we move on to factors on which resistance of a conductor depends. So there are three factors in which resistance of a conductor depends. First one is length of the conductor. Length of the conductor, you can write L, the symbol. And second one is area of cross section of the conductor. Area of cross section of the conductor, you can write it as A. Nature or resistivity of the material. Okay, here this is the formula. R is equal to rho L by A. Okay, these formulas are very important because they give you numerical, so that you have to apply this formula, and this formula carries marks. Here R is equal to resistance. Okay, and here rho. Rho stands for resistivity of the material. Okay, resistivity of the material. L stands for length of the conductor. And A stands for area of cross-section, area cross-section of the conductor also can add. Okay, R is equal to resistance, rho is equal to resistivity of the material, L stands for length of the conductor, area stands for area of cross-section. Okay, SI unit of resistance is ohmmeter. SI unit of resistance is ohmmeter. Ohmmeter. I will tell some important point. So when the length of the wire increases, resistance also increases. When the length of the wire increases, resistance also increases, so that the electric current decreases. Okay? When the length of the wire increases, resistance also increases and electric current decreases. Okay, and when the length of the wire decreases, resistance also decreases and electric current increases. Okay, and now what is rheostat? What do you mean by rheostat? So rheostat is a device or a variable resistor which is used to alter the electric current without changing its potential difference. Okay, what do you mean by rheostat? Rheostat is a device and it is a variable resistor which is used to alter the electric current without changing its potential difference. In electrical heating devices, electrical coils are made up of alloys. Why is that? Because alloys do not get oxidized easily in air when heated, but the metals do get oxidized. So instead of metals, they are made up of alloys. And tungsten. Tungsten is a metal which is used in a filament lamp. Okay, to prevent oxidation in the filament lamp, they fill up with nitrogen gas. Okay, tungsten is a metal in which it is used in filament lamp to prevent oxidation. They fill up nitrogen gas inside. So, we are in the last topic. topic of this video, alloys and their constituents. So there are three alloys, constantin, manganese and nichrome or nichrome, however you can pronounce. So here, constantin, you have to find out the constituents. Constantin, you can find CO. CO, you can write it as copper, and here N, nickel. Okay, copper and nickel are the constituents of constantin. Manganese, here only you can get manganese. And here you can add copper and here nickel. So there are three constituents for manganese, copper, nickel and manganese. You can get any two. Okay. And lastly, nichrome or nichrome. So here nichrome. Here itself you get to know as it's chromium. Chromium and iron. And you can write three constituents or you can write only two constituents for each. Thank you.
To 1.5 present here, myself Suraksha Shetty and my register number is 419. Today I am going to give a presentation on chemical reactions and equations. So what is chemical reaction? Chemical reaction is a reaction in which chemical change takes place. There are mainly four types of chemical reactions. They are combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction and double displacement reaction. Later we are going to learn about exothermic reaction, endothermic reaction, rancidity, corrosion, oxidation and reduction. So our first topic is combination reaction. The word combination means combining. In combination reaction is a type of chemical reaction in which two or more reactants combine together to form a single product. For example, Mg plus O here adds to MgO. Here magnesium combines with oxygen to form magnesium oxide. Decomposition reaction is a type of chemical reaction in which a single product decomposes or splits into two or more chemical products. There are three types of decomposition reaction. They are thermal decomposition, electrolytic decomposition and photolytic decomposition. Thermal decomposition means the splitting of reactants in the presence of heat. Electrolytic decomposition is a type of decomposition reaction in which splitting takes place in the presence of electricity. Here we come across an experiment called as electrolysis of water. Photolytic decomposition means the splitting of reactants in the presence of light. For example, Ag plus Cl2, AgCl give rise to Ag plus Cl2. Here silver chloride decomposes or splits into silver and chlorine. The next type of chemical reaction is displacement reaction. Displacement reaction is a type of chemical reaction in which a more electropositive metal changes its position into a less electropositive metal to form a new product. For example, CuSO4 plus Fe gives rise to FeSO4 plus Cu. Here, copper from the copper sulfate solution is displaced by the iron to produce FeSO4, that is ferrous sulfate, and copper remains in the cell. The fourth type of chemical reaction is double displacement reaction. Double displacement reaction is a type of chemical reaction in which two metals displaces themselves to form a new product. For example, BaCl2 plus Na2SO4 give rise to BaSO4 plus NaCl. Here, barium sulfate and barium chloride and sodium sulfate is give rise to NaCl, that is sodium chloride or salt, and barium sulfate. Here, barium sulfate is a precipitate. And it is an example for precipitation reaction. So we have a new question. What is precipitation reaction? Precipitation reaction is a type of double displacement reaction in which we get an insoluble substance in the product. Next unit is exothermic and endothermic reaction. What is exothermic reaction? Exothermic reaction is a type of reaction in which heat is released along with the product. For example, CH4 plus O2 gives rise to CO2 plus H2O plus heat. Here CH4, that is fuel, when it is burnt in the presence of oxygen, gives rise to carbon dioxide, water and heat. Endothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction is a type of chemical reaction in which heat is observed during the chemical reaction. For example, dissolving of NaCl or common salting water. The next unit is oxidation, reduction and redox reaction. Oxidation is a process in which addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen takes place in a chemical reaction. For example, Mg plus O2 gives rise to MgO. Here, Mg, that is magnesium, oxidizes into magnesium oxide. Reduction. Reduction is a process in which addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen takes place. For example, ZnO plus C gives rise to Zn plus CO. Here, zinc oxide, that is ZnO, reduces into zinc. The next topic is redox reaction. What is redox reaction? Redox reaction is a type of reaction in which we can observe both reduction and oxidation. Corrosion and rancidity. What is corrosion? Corrosion is when metals are oxidized in the presence of air, they lose their luster and strength. This is called as corrosion of metals. The best example for corrosion is rusting of iron. Rancidity. When oil and food items are oxidized in air, they change their smell and taste. This is called as rancidity. To prevent rancidity, the food items are contained or stored in an airtight container. Food packets are filled with inert gases like nitrogen to prevent rancidity. Now I am going to end my presentation. Thank you.
My name is Nishita and my register number is 269. Today I am going to write Ohm's Law. Potential difference at the ends of a conductor is directly proportional to the electric current at the constant temperature. The equation for Ohm's law is V is equal to IR.